A man stands in the doorway like a small child. Angry fists. She lies in her bed, her head buried in her pillow. And she stares at the moon. He speaks to her all the words she's heard too many times before. And pretty soon she just lets his voice fade away. And she thinks, this was a gradual steel frost that started with cold feet and ended with numb hearts. It is one satisfying sex, but now no longer is. It was once filled with all the possibilities of new china or old stone. But now it's exaggerated and waterlogged, no longer what these hands had intended, and still I cry in my sleep. He always said I was too sensitive. But I say, at least I never meant to make him cry. At least I never meant to make him hurt that way. Brushes her hair. He's already asleep. By the time she goes to lay back down, she thinks, my God, what am I doing here? My bones have grown tired of his hunger, of his gray eyes. I feel that if I were to stay one more night here, I'd die or explode, or worse yet, just fade away. There have been days so dark when I felt like August, and that I soon too would turn to fall. He always said I was too sensitive. If I dared to care so much, the world could kill me that way. I wonder if he's only half alive, or if he simply has always lacked such subtlety. 'Cause I say, at least I never meant to make him cry. At least I never meant to make him hurt this way. No, I never meant to make him cry. I never meant to make him hurt this way. Yes, it's true. As though they were the wings for her freedom. She gets up and goes to the drawer. It's a moment in which anything could happen. She gets out some clothing and puts him in a bag and leaves him sleeping while she heads for